Well, this isn't going to be an earth-shattering video, but I'm in the mood to do another one. I find a lot of stuff, and so does my husband, and I do look, you know, at tag sales, yard sales, you know, whatever you want to call them. And I got this fancy set of cookware a few years ago. And this is the sort of thing that would be, I suppose, a wedding gift. And I don't know the story behind this, but I was really glad to get it. And when you get this stuff, and it's good quality stuff, take the time to read the materials with it. Now, this is a stainless steel cooking set. And whenever you cook with stainless steel, you really should not salt whatever you're cooking in there. It does break down and wear down the stainless steel too quickly. And I checked this. I know some other people have checked it. It's really true. Also, I did consulting work for ArcelorMittal Steel here in France for quite some time. And I still know people there, and I've checked with them on this too. Now, this is a chicken, which my spouse, who does pretty much all the shopping now because he's a stingy maniac, and I love it because I'm disabled. I do the cooking, he does the shopping, asked me if I wanted a chicken, and I was very surprised, and I said, yes, please. So he got this one, and it's a free-range chicken, and I used to really like chicken, and I love poultry, but my cholesterol levels were dangerously high for many years, and I have found that just by eliminating all poultry from our diets, from my diet, the cholesterol levels went to normal. It only took about 6 months. So go figure. You know, a lot of people think that chicken is low fat, you know, like it, especially if you take the skin off. You know, that's just not true. Most pork has less fat than chicken. And I kept buying factory farmed chicken here, and my spouse got really fed up with me for doing that, and he made me look at a documentary about factory farmed chicken, and I was cured. That being said, I still like to have poultry about 6 times a year. This chicken got marinated in dried ginger, a little bit of sesame oil. Now, normally sesame oil should not be used for cooking, but I used it in the marinade. Sesame oil is more a glaze, like right at the end after the cooking, or for cold things such as salads. You know, it just doesn't do well with high temperatures, with temperatures, with heat. And I had several Asiatic sauces in the refrigerator, and I wanted to get rid of them. They were almost used up, so they went on here. No salt, no pepper, just a little fennel powder. And I just washed it well. There's nothing in the cavity. The thing that I like about this fancy cooker is that the bird is raised up. The sauce is on the bottom already. This is some of the marinade. And I will have to stop it and take some of the sauce off the bottom and baste, but it's got a nice tight glass lid on it. Now, if you want it to brown, you have to take the lid off the last, you know, few minutes. And remember, always let your meat sit for a while. Never add salt to red meat while it's raw, because that seizes it up. And generally, I don't add salt anymore. This also has some rice wine vinegar in it, some fancy dark soy sauce. Soy products are very unhealthy. All of them are. You know, it's like in life, when they tell you something's good for you, such as drinking milk, you better question that, okay? They probably have an agenda. I'll just leave you with that thought in mind. I don't know what I'm going to do with this when it's cooked, except I think part of it's going to be a curried chicken salad. and part of it's just going to be plain. And since my spouse was born here in France, he really does not like barbecue. The French do not like large quantities of food. They only like one or two things on the plate in as I've said, in small portions, in courses. They actually, at home, they use a little piece of bread to wipe off the plate, so there aren't a lot of dishes to wash. A lot of the French don't have dishwashers. They wash their dishes by hand. And they really don't like sauces. They don't like a lot of different foods mixed in. There are exceptions to this. They like they don't like refrigerators. They don't like cold things. They don't like ice. They prefer things at room temperature and kept separate so that you can savor and appreciate the and taste the quality of whatever it is you are eating. So as you can see, this is just what I'm doing. I had a really, really hard day today. Very tiring. It was too exhausting when I was in Paris this morning to even make a clip for you. The tramway was disgusting this morning. It was crowded. The meeting I had to go to was like 3 hours of absolute hell in French, and I really didn't understand too much of it, frankly. I hope that some of the information in this little video is helpful for you. Please don't buy any factory farmed meat, and really consider poultry. Consider getting it out of your diet, except for a few times a year. I know, who would have thought, you know? And I'm female, last I checked, and chicks like chicken, but you know, really. And I like guinea fowl. I have some videos up about it. It's called pintade in French, P-I-N-T-A-D-E. I have some videos up on that. So wish me luck cooking this. It's going to go in here for about an hour, but with this nice glass lid, I'll be able to see what's happening, and I'll be able to make a decision as to, you know, how much I'm going to baste it and whether I want it to be brown or not. All right, people.